Hello, I'm Mary Rose Rodriguez, and I'm going to tell you about the Data Privacy Act of 2012, or RA 10173.
The Philippines has a growing and important business process management and health information technology industry. The total IT spending reached 7 billion in 2018. Filipinos are heavy social media users. As of 2019, there are 73 million on Facebook, 7.8 million in Twitter, and 11 million in Instagram.
In the context of the rapid growth of the digital economy and increasing international trade of data, the Philippines strengthened its privacy and security protections.
The Philippines has a relatively young data privacy regime. The Data Privacy Act, RA 10173, as well as RA 10175, or the Cybercrime Prevention Act, were only enacted in 2012. Although some countries passed data protection laws as early as the 1970s, the Philippines' regulatory body, the National Privacy Commission, NPC, was formally organized only in 2016. It issued implementing rules and regulations and circulars in the same year. Nevertheless, the country is on its way to developing a stable framework of privacy protection as technological innovations liberalize information sharing. What is RA 10173, DPA? RA 10173, or the Data Privacy Act, protects individuals from unauthorized processing of personal information that is, one, private, not publicly available, and two, identifiable, where the identity of the individual is apparent, either through direct attribution or when put together with other available information.
How is it implemented? RA 10173 protects and maintains the right of customers to confidentiality by setting a legal list of rules for companies to regulate the collection, handling, and disposal of all personal information. Companies legally responsible for keeping their customers' data protected from third parties or any form of misuse, internally or externally.
What does that mean for data collectors/companies? The Act applies to any process of personal data by anyone in government or private sectors. All personal data must have legitimate reasons for collection, as well as should be clear to both parties giving and receiving information. With that being said, all collection must be done with the customer's proper consent. All personal information used must also be relevant, solely used for its intended and state purposes. Companies must protect customer information from collection to proper disposal, avoiding access from unauthorized parties.
Magandang araw po muli mga kaguro, kaibigan at kaempleyado. Ito po ulit ang inyong lingkod, si Atty. Resto Tobias Adarayan, na palaging nagpapaalala sa inyo that ignorance of the law excuses no one from compliance the week. What are these personal information, personal sensitive information, and privileged information? Pag sinabi natin personal information, it refers to any information whether recorded in a material form or not. Number one, from which the identity of individual is apparent. Yung pangalan mo, it is a personal information. Your sex is a personal information. Be reasonably or directly asserted by the entity holding the information. And number three, when put together, other information would directly and certainly identify an individual. So any information that will certainly or directly identify an individual, that is called a personal information. Information, you can share this to a limited group of person. Doon sa mga kakilala mo lang at sa ka-close friends mo. Ito naman natin yung sensitive personal information. Ang sensitive personal information, this can be shared to others. However, it has a risk and consequences. So, kailangan pag-ingatan po natin yung personal sensitive information dahil may kaukulang risk and consequence kung ito po ay isi-share natin sa public. Ito nga po, pinagbabawal na i-post sa social media yung ating report cards ng ating mga estudyante. Okay. Because report card natin involves personal sensitive information. Yun yung learner's reference number, age, yung sex ng bata. Babawal po yung pag-post ng report card sa Facebook. maaari din itong gayahin at mapeke yung mga card. Kaya pinag-iingatan natin na mangyari yung mga ganong sitwasyon. The personal information involves individual race, ethnic origin, marital status, age, color, religious, philosophical, political affiliation. So, bawal po na basta-basta na lang natin ibigay sa ibang tao ang impormasyon ng isang empleyado. Halimbawa, isa kang principal at may humingi sa'yo na isang tao na po natin basta-basta ma-share yung sensitive personal information. Halimbawa, isa kang principal, school head, mayroong isang tao na pumunta sa'yo, humingi ng age, ng color and religious affiliations ng isang teacher. Maari mo bang basta-basta na lang iligay yung information na yun sa kanya? Hindi po maaari because you will be violating the Data Privacy Act. Atin na sensitive personal information, individual health, education, genetic or sexual life, or to any proceedings or any offense committed or alleged to have been committed by individual. Nga po yung ating mga kaso po sa Department of Education, it is confidential. Basta ipagsasabi sa ibang tao, sasabihin mo na si ganito ay mayroong kaso na ganito because you will be violating the Data Privacy Act. And a government issued personal number such as SSS, GSIS, PhilHealth, Pag-ibig, LTO, and previous current health records and tax returns. Kaibigan, yung ating PRC license card, pinagbabawal yan na i-post sa social media. Yung iba sinasabi, after million years, nakapag-renew na rin ako ng aking card. Tapos nandoon lahat yung information sa kanyang card. Mali po yan because your card involved personal sensitive information na maaring magaya ng iba. Diba, makuha yung inyong license number at magamit pa yan sa panluloko. So yun po yung iniiwasan natin. Kung ay school head o mga principal, mayroong humingi sa inyo ng isang tao o kaya isang institution. Humihingi ng mga GSIS number, humihingi ng Pag-ibig number, humihingi ng employee number ng inyong mga teachers. Huwag nyo basta-basta ibibigay because it is sensitive personal information. Hindi yan basta-basta binibigay sa ibang tao. Maliban na lamang kung mayroong napatunayan niya na mayroong legitimate purpose. Mamaya, tatalakayin natin yan, mga kaibigan. Punta naman natin yung privilege information. Unang-una sa privilege information is husband or wife cannot testify against one another without consent on any communication received by either in confidence. So ikaw po ay hindi maaring makapagtistigo laban sa iyong asawa. Maliban na lamang kung ikaw mismo ang nag-file ng kaso laban sa iyong asawa, maaari kang makapag-testify. Ang logic ng batas, dahil kung lahat ng information na nalaman mo sa iyong asawa, ay maaari mong ipagsabi kahit kanino abae, wala nang mag-aasawa. Dahil malalaman ng buong mundo ang iyong sikreto. Client relationship is also a privileged information. Hindi maaaring ipagsabi sa iba ng isang abogado ang kanyang nalaman ng impormasyon mula sa kanyang kliyente. Because it will be a violation of Data Privacy Act. It is a privileged information. Physician-client relationship. Hindi rin maaaring ipagsabi ng isang doktor, na isang physician, ang kanya ma-impormasyon na nalaman sa isang pasyente. Halimbawa, ang isang pasyente pumunta sa isang doktor ng medical advice at nalaman ng doktor na siya ay mayroong HIV or AIDS. Hindi niya maaaring ipagsabi sa buong mundo na si patient A ay may AIDS. Minister, press person making confession. So ang mga pare o kaya ang mga ministro o kaya yung mga pastor, yung mga humihingi sa kanila ng pagpukumpisal, hindi maaring sabihin ng mga pare, hindi maaring sabihin ng pare kung ano yung mga kasalanan na nalaman niya mula sa tao na humingi sa kanya ng pagpukumpisal. Yun po ay privileged information. Then, public officer given information in official confidence. Yung mga public officer din na nalaman mo ang impormasyon na yon in your official capacity as public officer, hindi mo yan maaring ipagsabi sa iba. You are a military officer. At nalaman mo na mo yung mga defense equipment ng Pilipinas. Hindi mo maaring i-divulge yan kasi it is a privileged information. And other information na nakarating sa iyo because of your position in the government. Pag-usapan natin yung data privacy principles. We have transparency, legitimate purpose, and proportionality. So ano nga ba yung data privacy principle? Paano pinapakita ang transparency? It must have consent, privacy notice and privacy policy. So kung hihingi ka ng mga personal information, personal private information, the person must have a consent. Bago mo ilabas ang kanyang information, dapat mayroon muna siyang consent. Kaya minsan pinapipirma tayo ng waiver dahil kung kinakailangan na i-share natin yung personal information galing sa isang tao, maaari niya itong gawin without violating the Data Privacy Act. Ang tanong, maaari mang i-share yung personal sensitive information? Yung personal information? Yes, maaari yang i-share as long as there is a consent or waiver on the part of the person subject of the data. Another principle is the so-called legitimate purpose. The processing of information shall be compatible with the declared and specified purpose. It must be not contrary to law, morals, or public policy. So, ang isang tao, ang isang institusyon na humihingi ng information mula sa data subject, dapat mayroon siyang legitimate purpose. Kaya nga, kinakailangan bago kayo makahingi ng information, dapat gumawa muna kayo ng kasulatan stating thereof the purpose why you are getting the information from that data subject. Kasi kung halimbawa, humihingi ka ng information para ipahiya ang tao o ang data subject, hindi yan maaaring gawin. So halimbawa, isa kang principal, mayroong isang tao na pumunta sa'yo o kaya institusyon na humihingi ng health record ng isang teacher. Ang purpose niya ay para ipahiya ang certain teacher na yon. Hindi yan maaari because it will be a violation of Data Privacy Act. All is proportionality. Processing of information shall be adequate, relevant, suitable, necessary, and not excessive in relation to the declared and specified purpose. Kailangan din po yung proportionality. Ibig sabihin, kung ano lang yung purpose, doon din nagli-limit yung information na hihingiin sa data subject. So halimbawa, doon sa ating school ID, bakit nga ba gumagawa tayo ng ID? For the purpose of identifying that a certain person is an employee of the company or employee of the office. So ang ilalagay mo lang na impormasyon, yung makakapagpatunay na siya nga ay empleyado ng gobyerno o kaya siya ang empleyado ng company. Hindi na dyan kinakailangan pa yung GSIS number, is yung TIN, yung added information, because it is not proportion to the purpose of having that ID.
What are the rights of the data subject? The data subject, or the individual sharing his or her personal information, has the following rights. 1. The right to be informed. Your personal data should never be collected, processed, and stored without your explicit consent. 2. The right to access, ask whether an organization holds your personal data, and to gain reasonable access to obtain your personal data. 3. The right to object. You can object if the personal data processing involved is based on consent or on legitimate interest.
4. The right to erasure or blocking. You have the right to suspend, withdraw, or order the blocking or destruction of your personal data. 5. The right to damages. You may claim compensation if you suffered damages due to inaccurate, incomplete, outdated, false, unlawfully obtained data. 6. The right to file a complaint if your personal information has been misused, maliciously disclosed, or improperly disposed.
7. The right to rectify, right to dispute, and have corrected any inaccuracy or error in your data. 8. The right to data portability assures your data are transferred, electronically moved, copied, in a secure manner. Who implements the DPA? The National Privacy Commission, NPC, is in charge of administering and implementing the DPA. It is also tasked to monitor and ensure compliance of the Philippines with international standards for personal data protection.
The major functions of the NPC are as follows. 1. Rulemaking. 2. Advisory. The NPC is the advisory body on matters related to personal data protection. 3. Public education. The NPC shall launch initiatives to educate the public about data privacy, data protection, and fair information, rights and responsibilities. 4. Compliance and monitoring. The body has compliance and monitoring functions to ensure personal information controllers comply with the law. It is also tasked to manage the registration of personal data processing systems. 5. Complaints and investigations. 6. Enforcement.
How to comply with the Data Privacy Act. If you are a personal information controller, you are required to comply with the following in accordance with the law. 1. Registration of Data Processing Systems, DPS. An individual or institution employing fewer than 250 employees need not register unless its data processing operations involve sensitive personal information of at least 1,000 individuals likely to pose a risk to the rights and freedoms of data subjects, or the processing is not occasional.
2. Appointment of a data protection officer in charge of ensuring compliance with the DPA. 3. Creation of a data breach response team that will immediately address security incidents or personal data breach. 4. Adoption of data protection policies that provide for data security measures and security incident management. 5. Annual report of the summary of documented security incidents and personal data breaches. And 6. Compliance with other requirements as may be provided by the NPC.
What should you do in the event of a data breach? The law requires a data breach notification within 72 hours upon knowledge of the breach or a reasonable belief that it has occurred to the NPC and the data subject. The notification is generally required when the breach involves sensitive personal information or any other information that may be used to enable identity fraud. This information has been acquired by an unauthorized person, and the acquisition is likely to give rise to a real risk of serious harm to the affected data subject.
The NPC may investigate the breach, depending on its nature, or if there is a delay or failure to notify. Inquiries may include on-site examination of systems and procedures.
What happens if I do not comply? Improper or unauthorized processing, handling or disposal of personal information can be penalized by imprisonment up to 6 years and a fine of not less than 500,000 pesos.
This information material is made for EDM 608 class under Dr. Nordy Chason Jr. of the West Visayas State University.